Hi, Phil with xenonsupply.com. Today we're installing HID Bi-Xenon headlights on a 2006 Honda Element. This installation is very common amongst other Honda vehicles. Let's pop the hood and get started. Here's what you need to do the installation. You will need a Cars World Standard kit, Bi-Xenon of course, with the wiring harness, with the relay, the two ballasts, and the H4 Bi-Xenon bulbs. You will also need a couple tools, some painter's tape, a 10mm socket, and a socket wrench, the zip ties that come in the kit, and some wire cutters. Before performing any installation on a vehicle, we must first remove the negative terminal on the battery. Take your 10mm socket and loosen the nut. This should pull away pretty easily. To prevent the terminals from touching again, take some painter's tape, just wrap it up. To get access to the driver's side headlight, we have to do a couple things here. We first have to remove a portion of the air intake. You should be able to release it by just jiggling it free here. Now the H4 connector has two tabs, one on each side. You should be able to press down and remove the connector. There is a rubber shroud here and a pull tab. Just pull that loose. The H4 bulb has a wire harness holding it in. Press down, and that should come out. And gently remove the H4 bulb. The passenger side is the same process. First, remove the connector. Remove the rubber shroud. Depress on the wire here. And remove the bulb gently. Because this is a Bi-Xenon kit, the wiring harness must be directly bolted to the battery for power. Your positive lead can be bolted to the battery here, and the negative lead can be bolted to the chassis following this grounding wire over here. Go ahead and remove the 25 amp fuse from the fuse box here, and remember to place it at the end of the installation. In order to mount the ballast in the engine compartment, we must assemble the provided mounting bracket. Go ahead and snap that one on. Use the provided nuts and bolts and tighten. This uses a standard Phillips head as well. As you can see, we've gone ahead and mounted the driver's side ballast between the battery and the frame. The zip ties are holding the ballast to the wiring harness that's going to the radiator housing. As you can see, there's one zip tie down here at the bottom and one zip tie right around this wiring harness right here. Now that we have the driver's side ballast mounted, we can go ahead and install the new HID light. The reflecting base has to be facing down, and the bulb has to be shown face up. When you put the new bulb in, make sure that the wire clip goes back on. Go ahead and give it a tug, make sure it's snug. Now these wires we're going to go ahead and connect male to female. This small wire here is the signal wire for high and low beam. You are going to use a
signal wire provided here. And connect the two together. Make sure that's snug. This wire here, the one that's closest to the relay, is going to connect to your driver's side ballast here. Make sure the clips go over the edge. It's nice and snug. This last wire here on the driver's side goes to the stock harness that you originally took off. The three prongs should line up exactly. All right, and that's the driver's side. As you can see, we've mounted the passenger side ballast to the same radiator wiring harness that's running along the chassis. I've used the two zip ties and the mounting brackets here. There's one zip tie around this bracket here, and one all the way at the bottom. Now that we have it mounted, we can go ahead and install the HID light. Remember to keep the reflector plate down and the bulb facing up. You're also going to want to take the plastic shroud, or the rubber shroud, and install it at the same time. Make sure it's snug. Replace the shroud. And connect your wires. You are going to take the male and female leads here from the ballast to the bulb. The small signal wire is going to be coming from the relay. And this wire will be going to the ballast. Make sure everything's nice and snug, and that's the passenger side. We've cleaned up all the wiring, running from the passenger side all the way along this portion of the chassis, and bundled up all the cables here for the wiring harness. We've gone ahead and put the 25 amp fuse back in its place, and reinstalled the intake. Let's go ahead and test these lights.